अच्छा ओके फाइन।
हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज सुवा एंड आई वर्क एट ट्रॉमा रिलीफ एंड वेलनेस सेंटर। वी हैव शहीर विद अस टुडे। शहीर, वुड यू लाइक टू इंट्रोड्यूस योरसेल्फ?
Well, first, my name is not Shavir, it's Shahir, and I work here at Trauma Release and Wellness Center as an associate clinical psychologist.
Okay, so today we are going to talk about youth and addiction, which I believe is a very important topic. So let's get right to it.
Yeah.
So, okay, Shahir, why do people, you know, get into addiction? Like, why does that happen?
So the question is that how do and why do people end up getting addicted, and why do people get addicted? So basically, to answer that question, we first need to understand is that there are three steps. The first step is the psychological part. The first step is the genetic part. The second is the psychological part, and the third is the social part. So the first genetic part, what it means is, and what is the presupposition is that someone in your family, someone from your family, from your immediate family or your ancestors, have had some kind of addiction, and that is present in your genes, right? Then the second part is the psychological part, and in that psychological part, what happens is that you are living in an environment which is not exactly very healthy for you, right? What this means is that the environment that you're living in, for example, it could be your home, it could be your workplace, it could be your school, it could be your college, and the environment, the people that you're surrounded with are not very supportive of you, right? And you feel that you're not able to live your life to the fullest.
Basically a very stressful life.
Yeah, basically a very stressful life. And the third one is the social usage. So what happens in the social part is that then you have friends who use drugs, right? And you go there and you use drugs. So these are the three ways that you could get addicted. You could get addicted to drugs or anything. But what you need to understand here is, and this is the important part, is that, for example, if you have just the genetic causes of getting addicted and the other two, psychological and social causes, are not there, you're not going to get addicted. Similarly, if you are only living in a stressful situation, your psychological environment is not ideal, and the other two, social and the genetic, is all right, you're not going to get addicted. If your social part is, you go out with your friends and you start to use up drugs and or something like that, again, that does not necessarily mean that you're going to get addicted. The only way that you get addicted is when all these three, the psychological, the sociological, and the genetic cause, they combine together. That is when you have a very high chance of getting addicted. What I mean is that, for example, you're not living in an ideal condition, your family is not very supportive, you feel that you're not able to perform fully, and on the other hand, you have friends, right? You have friends who do smoke and who do drugs. So you think that, oh, I can do drugs, occasionally and all that. But what you don't know is that maybe you have that genetic predisposition.
So what you're trying to say is, if you have all three factors, then only...
Yeah, exactly. That all three factors are necessary for a person to get addicted.
Okay, so if like my life is very stressful and my friends are doing drugs, that does not necessarily mean that I might get addicted.
Yeah, it does not. But only if all the three factors are all together, that is when you...
So, when we talk about addiction, is it only drugs?
Okay. So this is a very good question, and we really got that question in our Instagram feed as well. So, what we and what people need to understand is that whenever we hear the word addiction, our mind directly goes towards, achha, ye toh nashe ki baat ho rahi, drugs ki baat ho rahi, right? So, what we need to understand is that there are two kinds of addiction, chemical addiction and non-chemical addiction, right? Chemical addiction ka kya matlab hota hai? Chemical addictions are any substance that is, made up using chemicals. It could be like your regular drugs, for example, cigarette is a chemical drug.
Nicotine
is, because it has nicotine. Caffeine is a chemical drug. Your usual drugs, LSD, heroin, hash, meth, etc. So yeah, these are your chemical drugs. इसके अलावा देर आर नॉन केमिकल ड्रग्स विच यू कैन ऑल्सो गेट एडिक्टेड टू एंड दैट इज एनीथिंग दैट इज नॉट मेड ऑफ केमिकल्स इट कुड बी यू नो लव एडिक्शन इट कुड बी सेक्स एडिक्शन इट कुड बी फूड एडिक्शन एंड सो ऑन एंड सो फोर्थ सो ये भी अच्छा सवाल है आपका क्योंकि बहुत सारे लोगों को बिल्कुल इस बारे में अंदाजा नहीं होता कि एडिक्शन सिर्फ इसके अलावा किसी और चीज़ की भी हो सकती है सो देर इज केमिकल एडिक्शन एंड देर इज नॉन केमिकल एडिक्शन that's a very common phenomenon. Yeah, that's a very common phenomenon that you mentioned that kids are getting addicted towards games and phones. Like, yes, definitely that happens. That would classify as a non-chemical drug.
Yeah. Okay. So, let's say that someone does get addiction. How do you get out of it?
You're trying to ask what's the way of recovery, right?
Yeah, like how do you recover from it?
Yeah, so the thing is that the recovery process, before we dive into the recovery process, what you need to understand or what people need to understand regarding the recovery of addiction is that addiction is a disease which is not curable. Addiction is a disease which is not curable, but it is manageable, right? Sounds surprising? इसका ये मतलब हुआ कि if a person is addicted, right? इसका ये मतलब है कि there won't be a day, there won't come a day when you'll be like, oh, I'm addiction free. सही है? Now the next question arises is कि हम इतने लोगों को जानते हैं कि वो 10 सालों से they are, you know, they haven't done any drugs or anything like that. So I'll come to that point later. सही है? तो again going back to the first point is कि addiction is a manageable disease but not curable. इसकी एग्जाम्पल उसी तरह से है जिस तरह से डायबिटीज़ की सही है इट्स एग्जैक्टली लाइक डायबिटीज़ फॉर एग्जाम्पल हाउ डू यू गेट डायबिटीज़ यू टेक इन अ लॉट ऑफ शुगर और यू हैव जेनेटिक्स जेनेटिक प्रीसपोजिशन एज वेल एंड देन यू गॉट एडिक्शन राइट यू गॉट डायबिटीज़ उसके बाद क्या होता है कि व्हाट हैपेंस इज के जो है क्या कहते हैं हाउ डू यू आई थिंक वी हैव अ I'll continue saying what क्या कहते हैं diabetes how it's again we'll do this again सही है so that people have an idea so what happens is कि जो है क्या कहते हैं addiction is like diabetes it's like diabetes because in diabetes you cannot be diabetes free ever अभी तक तो ऐसा नहीं है सही है अभी तक we do not have an इलाज for diabetes right What do people with diabetes do is that they, as long as they are taking their daily insulin, their diabetes is managed, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, but the day they don't take their insulin, their diabetes level shoot up. It's the same with addiction. It's a lifelong process.
So, what you're saying is that you can never get out, like you can never fully recover from it, but it's manageable.
Yeah, it's again, the thing is like it's not curable.
It's not curable.
With management, There can come a point where you don't use drugs for a very long period of time, right?
But then you can always go back.
Yeah, but there's always a going back. What we need to remember from this is that an addict can never be a social user. सही है? इस बात का मतलब मैं समझा देता हूँ कि what does it mean when I say an addict can never be a social user is कि अगर मैं कभी addict रहा था, सही है? As I was an addict and I went into you know focus groups and I went into the treatment program. उसके बाद इट्स बिन 5 years इट्स बिन 10 years आई हैवंट यूज्ड अ ड्रग आई कांट थिंक के ओ अब मैंने इतना टाइम हो गया मैंने ड्रग यूज़ नहीं किया तो आई कैन यू नो डू इट जस्ट वन टाइम बिकॉज इफ आई डू इट जस्ट वन टाइम द साइकिल रिपीट्स अगेन
सही है
सही है तो दिस इज हाउ एडिक्शन इज
सो ओके नाउ दैट वी
How does one manage it? Okay, again, one question. Good question. There are different steps that people can take. How to do the recovery process? Where to start with the recovery process? So there are different, support groups that people can join. Support groups can there are AA group meetings, there are NA group meetings, Narcotics Anonymous, Alcohol Anonymous meetings. They can go there, and in those meetings, they do follow that 12-step abstinence model. So yeah. And it's a whole model. We can talk about that later as well.
Okay. So now I was wondering. Like if you are a family member, if you're a friend of someone who you think might be getting addicted, like how do you recognize that, or how do you, you know, detect if someone's getting, might get addicted?
So again, a good question. What are the, some symptoms that you can see in someone that is getting addicted, right?
Yeah.
So the thing is that, for example, if you know someone that you suspect that he uses drugs or anything, and he might get addicted. So what are some symptoms that you would be able to identify? So there are two very basic simple symptoms that you can identify, that you can use to identify the addiction in someone. Number one is powerlessness, right? Now, what do I mean by powerlessness? Powerlessness basically means that the person who is using the drugs cannot with 100% certainty say that he is not going to use it anymore. He is powerless over the compulsion of using that drug, right? Ki matlab uska apne upar bas nahi chal raha hai ki wo jo hai kabhi bhi, for example, if I am an addict and you'll ask me ki do you think you can never use drugs anymore, मैं तुम्हें ये जवाब दूंगा कि वो मैंने पहले भी पास में तीन हफ्ते ड्रग्स यूज नहीं किए, तो आई कैन डू दैट. बट इवन व्हेन आई एम सेइंग दैट आई नो इट इन माय सेल्फ दैट आई एम यू नो नॉट सर्टेन अबाउट इट. आई डोंट थिंक मैं एक ऐसा पॉइंट आएगा कि मैं जिंदगी भर के लिए यू नो आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू नॉट यूज द ड्रग्स. सो देयर इज दिस पावरलेसनेस फेयर. एंड द नंबर टू एंड द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट इज द अनमैनेजेबिलिटी. क्या मतलब है अनमैनेजेबिलिटी का? Okay, the person who is an addict is not able to manage the tasks that he used to do before getting addicted. क्या मतलब हुआ इस बात का? कि for example, if I used to be a high achiever और मैं जो है क्या कहते हैं स्कूल में अच्छी पढ़ाई करता था, तो उसके बाद जब से मैं addicted हो गया हूँ तो I am not able to perform well in my school, right? मेरी पढ़ाई down हो गई है, मेरी जो है family के साथ जो अच्छे relation थे, I am not able to manage those relationships. I am not able to perform well in my work. I am not able to perform well in my, you know, if I was playing good cricket, I am not able to do that. I am not able to make time and to go and play cricket, or I am not able to make time to go to the gym and, you know, do the workout. So, usme unmanageability ka part aa jata hai. So, again, to answer or to summarize what my answer is, ke how do you know that someone is getting addicted? There are two things, powerlessness and unmanageability. Powerlessness, the person does not have a control over their compulsion to use the drugs, and unmanageability is that they can't, you know, manage themselves doing their daily tasks.
Oh, okay. So like, so again, coming from like a friend or a family member's perspective,
yeah,
if you do realize or if you do see these symptoms in someone, how do you like confront them? Because if they're not, you know, like accepting, or if they're in denial, okay, you know, no, I'm not addicted, like I need control and stuff. So how do you confront
that?
Because they are
going to
get defensive, right?
Okay. So you're talking about the talk, where you talk to that person,
yeah,
hey,
exactly.
Oh, I think there's a problem.
Yeah.
As a family member, I understand how this could be a very hard thing to do.
Yeah.
But this is going to be a conversation that is never going to be an easy conversation, right? Because, for example, it is a classic key trait of an addict that person is in denial until a certain thing happens. We'll come back to that later. They remind me to come back to that later. So, if I feel, okay, for example, you are an addict and we live together, and I feel that you have some symptoms, or you're my friend, and I feel that you have some symptoms based on the powerlessness and unmanageability, mujhe my nazar aa rahi hai, and I think that you are going towards a path of destruction, and as a friend of yours, I am really concerned about you and I want to talk to you about it. So if I talk to you about ke yaar tu bhai, I think the drugs that you're using, I think that's, you know, really damaging you, and you're not how you used to be. So the key factor, or the classic factor that a drug addict exhibits, is denial, right? You're not going to accept this. Because agar tumne wo accept kar liya ke jo hai kya kehte hain, ha tum sahi keh rahe ho, and I think that this is, you know, not good for me too, then you're not addict, or you're not at that point right now.
Okay.
So this conversation, because when there's denial, and when jab main ek cheez bol raha hu tum deny kar rahi hogi, so this is going to be a difficult conversation.
So when there's denial, or when the addict is not accepting, does treatment really work then?
So the number one point, the number one point of treatment, or the number one point of the support groups and the AA and NA meetings is that to accept the powerlessness of the addict, right? So, to jab tak wo acceptance does not come from within, tab tak wo nahi hoga. सही है. उसका मतलब वो अगर मैं अपने भाई को ज़बरदस्ती किसी ए या एन ए मीटिंग में भेज रहा हूँ, सपोर्ट ग्रुप में भेज रहा हूँ, बट उसको लगता है कि सब बकवास है, सब फजूल है, इट्स नॉट गोइंग टू वर्क आउट, तो इट्स नॉट गोइंग टू वर्क अनटिल एंड अनलेस ही डज नॉट एक्सेप्ट द पावरलेसनेस दैट यू नो कि उसका इसके अंदर कंट्रोल है या वो है, तो इट्स नॉट गोइंग टू वर्क आउट. इट हैज द एक्सेप्टेंस हैज टू कम फ्रॉम विदिन.
So like you were mentioning before, okay, there are a lot of support groups for these people. But like support groups and rehabs and everything, they're so expensive. Like not everyone can afford these treatments. So what do people do if they can't really afford?
Again, I think this question has a lot to do with the lack of information that people have around them. So, jo hai kya kehte hain, specifically talking about drug addiction and in relevance to Pakistan and in our society, I think that there are a lot of free things that are going around. So what people can do is that they can, you know, just Google Alcohol Anonymous or Narcotics Anonymous free services in Pakistan, and there are a lot of support groups that are absolutely free. Yeah, so you know, you just have to go and register and sit in the meeting, and you know, that's the first step towards your recovery process.
So it's free.
Yeah, it is.
Okay, so yeah, you were talking about the
12-step abstinence model. But before going to that, I would like to come back because I forgot to mention the point. Yeah, so what happens is that you were talking about the conversation, right?
Yeah,
how to have that conversation. So again, as I mentioned, that there is not going to be an easy way to do that conversation, but there is a but, right? So, but what happens is that there always comes a point in the life of a drug addict or an addict that he hits rock bottom, right? That rock bottom could be, you know, economic rock bottom. Like for example, they lose all their life savings. हम सुनते हैं कि जो है क्या कहते हैं नशे में जो है सब कुछ गवा दिया. That person does not have anything anymore. Yeah, jo hai, when they're high and they do something that might end them up in trouble, right?
Like an overdose.
Yeah, like an overdose, like a near death experience. Yeah, where you know they might end up going to jail. They just jail jaate reh gaye. Right? To koi aisa log ya fir usually bhi is tarah se bhi hota hai, like in drug addiction, what happens is ke a close friend dies due to drug overdose, right? So that also is somewhere near near-death experience. So when you hit rock bottom, say yeah, that is when the acceptance starts to come. Say ki haan, I think there is a problem. Say yeah, so until that point comes, when that point comes and you talk to the person about the problem that he is having,
okay,
that might
so
be the right
what
time.
You're saying is confronting when they are, you know, very low or different.
I mean, as a family member, I wouldn't want my brother to go towards that point, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to have conversations with him before, but that's not going to be a very pleasant conversation, right? I'm only saying that this conversation works more when the person has hit rock bottom.
So you said that when a person hits rock bottom, that's when they start accepting.
Yeah.
So like, is it true for every addict? Is that the case for every addict? Okay, whenever they hit rock bottom, that is the only
The answer to this question is कि अगर इससे पहले acceptance आ रही है, तो either वो उससे पहले rock bottom hit कर चुका है, या फिर that person was not an addict. क्योंकि addiction की जो number one point is they're in denial, right? They don't think they have a problem with it. Until and unless that happens. तो what you are saying is कि अगर उससे acceptance आ रही है, तो अगर उससे पहले acceptance आ रही है रॉक बॉटम हिट होने से पहले, तो उसका मतलब ये है कि वो एडिक्शन की कैटेगरी में क्लासिफाई नहीं हुआ है अभी तक. मतलब दैट पर्सन माइट बी यूजिंग दैट ड्रग, बट ही स्टिल हैज सम पावर ओवर इट. एडिक्शन तभी क्लासिफाई होती है कि दैट पर्सन इज यू नो पावरलेस ओवर दैट कंपल्शन.
अच्छा, पावरलेस. या या दैट
मेक्स
सेंस.
सो यू वर नॉट टू टॉक अबाउट द 12 स्टेप एडिक्शन मॉडल.
या
सो द 12 स्टेप एडिक्शन मॉडल it's a very detailed model, but I'll just go through the gist over it. And what happens in the 12-step model is that basically when you go to support groups and you go to the AA or NA meetings, what happens is that there's a whole program, 12-step abstinence model, and in that program, the gist of that program is that number one thing is that you accept, as an addict, you start to accept that you're powerless. You don't have the power over that the disease, and now you're going to work consciously over not using that thing anymore, right? And you're going to take support and you're going to take help from others, from people around you in that meeting. And this is the whole model. This is basically the gist of the model, right? So basically what happens is that they are managing the drug usage by going to that therapy session every day, and every day my will is reinforced, right? Okay. So this is basically how the 12-step model works.
So if I am someone who uses drugs,
yeah,
and I wanna know more about it, like I don't wanna become an addict,
okay,
basically. So like, are there any resources or are there any things that you have?
Mm-hmm. There are basically if you Google, then you will get tons of material.
Like,
but
if there's a nice book or something.
Yeah, about the book, there are two books that I would like to recommend for our viewers and for you as well. Narcotics Anonymous and Alcoholics Anonymous, How It Works and Why. It's definitely a great book, and I would recommend you to read it and anyone who else is interested. So yeah. We do have questions,
but we can answer them in the details. Yeah. Okay. So I think that we're done.
We're done.
We've addressed pretty much a lot about youth and addiction. So I guess we'll end the session now.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Shahi. Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you
here
for having me, and thank you for having this discussion. I hope we do this again sometime on some other topic.
Yeah. I hope we do this again. So thank you everyone who joined the live session.
Office.
We'll see you next time. Thank you.